It was good, your boy Mr. Wonka 7. Updates available. Updates are always available, man. I'm gonna give the same answer I gave a year ago. Not interested. Ordinarily, this is not a recording time for me. But you know what? That's why I'm gonna record now. Without resorting to using a guide. Are there any like ports around here? I don't think so. Big eyes. Something about big eyes just looks extremely familiar. I didn't even get to see the animation for the swing all the way. Where big eyes disintegrating. I did see a swing animation, but something was missing in all of that. That my untrained eye couldn't see. The shark is getting on my last nerves. Just kidding. That shark ain't doing nothing to me of value. Okay, I'm getting in box. Oh, just some ANCAP. That always happens around the summer. ANCAP's comment on my really old videos when I was an anarcho-capitalist and saying all that ridiculous stuff. But now I'm just saying ridiculous alt-right stuff, so there's not much of an improvement if it wasn't for the fact that the opposite end is just so worse. So much more worse. Go ahead, burn them all. Exploring the inner. This is Wild Arms. I ain't gonna touch on Wild Arms today. This is a cheat day for me. This is some infomercial type music. There is a lot of land we have not yet explored. See all those like orange boxes? Just look at that. It's amazing. My face just feels cheesy right now. Cavern of Earth, the world, Giant's Cave. Guess. Okay, let me get this one straight. What's the cancel button? Alright. So which one's the land that has Cavern of the Earth? I'll fight dirty. Why not? It's not like anyone cares for Sahajins anyway. In general, I do have an idea of how I'm going to go about the rest of this. Buccaneer. So around here should be a dock. That's what I'm looking for. I can't wait till we upgrade our weapons, because that coral sword looks cool for the first few minutes, and then the more you look at it, the more it looks stupid. Good thing you only see it for like a few, like a split second when you start swinging it around in battle, but. So. So I gotta be pointed at the southern tip and I gotta go west. So never eat southern. I could just stare for hours at this weird stuff. Well, I see a dock, but what's over here? Another dock. What's up, dock? I remember being so intimidated by these guys. Let's see if they're worth the hype I gave them. Oh, I just realized I have freaking Vivi. He's probably gonna go last. So we're gonna be seeing a lot of stupid stuff happen. Alright, so the enemies give out some decent EXP right now. I mean, you'll always see some kind of land formation like this in a 2D Final Fantasy game. I don't know why. They just like cluttered up forests with towns in them. Just one place that has that. You don't see that with 7, 8, and 9. Those places with world maps, but everything else, yeah. This game just makes me love the color blue. I've said it before, I really don't like the color blue, except in the context of this game, because the sprites, so like even the houses here, and the rivers, and the seas, and blue just looks completely different. Ah, great, they inflated the price of the towns and stuff, the inns. At least the knees aren't that much more expensive. I'll look to see if they have anything interesting on sale. Mithril mail. buckler. Good. Okay. Get those whack-ass gloves. Okay, you got a shield. You got a shield. All the more reasons that you shouldn't... If you're going to buy an NES game, you shouldn't have thieves on your party. They're just worthless. Okay, well, I won't have access to exit just yet. As you can see, pretty soon I will have access to something like that. But for now, we gotta wait. And that's all the more painful. This is AOE. This is... Let me actually look at the numbers for a second. No. I guess I only have one reason to have a black mage in. I don't really care about all that. So, a mithril sword. And just like that, I feel all the more better. This dude's sleeping. I want to talk to the townspeople. I don't know, I feel really social today, but not real social. Anything but that. I just want to talk to some fake motherfuckers right now. That sounds good. Okay, cop one of these. Cop three of those, that way I can use it twice on both my magic users. And I'm getting some shut-eye. I wonder if I went to the right town. Man, the Game Boy Advance graphics. Yeah, I'm glad this never got an SNES remake. The sprites would have looked better, but the color palette would have been horrible. So what's the name of this town? Okay, this is the correct town. It's north of the magic shop. Okay, this is where I'm supposed to go. I remember this as a kid. I thought that after you beat the fourth boss, you would go here and then the credits would just roll or some shit. The fourth, like, elemental fiend. Okay, so this is the guy that made the prophecy. Remember in episode one how in Cornelia they kept talking about Lucan's prophecy and how he came up with the fact that we're the four warriors of light. This is that dude. He looks like Captain Crunch, though. I don't understand why he looks like that. Like, I could understand Quaker Oats. Because that Quaker Oats guy, he looks like if you get him mad, he'll do damage on you. Freaking Captain Crunch? Hola. So now you can freely move around like this. It's quite nice. If things don't work out too well, I may need to level up some more and then buy Thundaga for my Black Mage. I wonder if you get into random battles. I don't remember very well. Oh, you do. Neo choose. Dark Kefka would have a fit if he saw this. Damn, these guys hit hard. Good thing I didn't waste MP. I was about to, though. So you see, that dude gave out a lot of EXP, so we all leveled up at the same time. As if we're all on the same track, even though we've splintered off, or pincered off, actually. You know those nerves in your shoulders where you might get pinched by like a jerk? Yeah, those nerves are really affecting me right now. Hopefully I could just spam Thuraga and get out of this situation. I don't need like Thundaga or something. Oh, wow. This is a nice place for EXP. Actually, it doesn't take much to level up in this version of Final Fantasy, That's right, go after butts. Well, lot of bite from these guys. White Croc. For a second, I read White Croc as White Ciroc. And that 9 unit of damage made all the difference in defeating him. I should get myself some potions so I don't have to use and abuse. White magic. Nah, I don't need it now. I'll say I don't need it in SpongeBob fashion, but I need it. Damn. First time we fought them, they were kind of hard. Not like Final Fantasy 13 hard, but still hard nonetheless. We need like an Asuna. Okay, I see it. I see it. It's a little maze-like. Nothing too bad. And now we're fighting these jokers. With only one level up that we've achieved, I wonder how we'll do here. So how many paragraphs for this dungeon? Well, the treasure checklist has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 22, 24, 25, 26, 7, 8, 9, 32 items. For every step you take, you lose, in lava, you lose one hit point. Again, I ain't nearly dead yet. I like fighting these guys. I'll bite. Fire elementals. Again, in the other dungeon, we're dealing with freaking... Earth elementals, but now we gotta reach a new threshold. Alright, finish him off, butts. Get him, butts! Yeah. Mithril Helm. So obviously he's not going to need that. I'm going to be rich by the time I'm done with this. It's like, and this is a good thing actually, it's like something is aggroing everyone to butts. Maybe it's the fact that he's the guy on the top. And if I switched the formation around, it would be someone else. But it's the most advantageous thing. And I like how they set it up in the beginning. Alright, just clobber him. Alright, stats. To that, head southwest until you can. This game could fuck you up if you forget what south, north, and east and west are. The cardinal directions. Because it's not meant to be convenient. It's meant to punish idiocy. Oh shit, you got blink? Yeah, that's gonna be real bad. Preemptive strike. I remember something from H.C. Bailey or my past instincts telling me, yo, don't play around with those guys. They're really dangerous. Get up on the Hydra's back. Okay. You know what I just noticed? I'm looking at the character's shoes right now, and the thief has like a pink thing of boots. Like everyone else, it makes sense. The warrior has like red armor, and he has, with like white accents, and he has red boots with white accents. The red mage has red armor with yellow accents or golden accents, and his shit matches up. It's red with golden accents. Okay, stats. Again, everyone's looking good. It'd be nice if this game had save points or just places where you can rest in the middle of a dungeon. That's not too big of a deal. I wasted 80. But with me, wasting isn't going to be wasting because it's going to be put to use. That was really good. Mithril helm, mithril gloves, high potion, tent. Something about it just looks so satisfying in a Freudian fashion. It's like, finally. Nice. Mithril axe, mithril shield, phoenix down. So I didn't have to spend big checks on a mithril axe. I got it. All this mithril stuff. And it doesn't really amount to much anyway. Let me check. You know how some Let's Players actually show their face while they're showing the game they're playing? I might need to do that just to explain those silent moments where I'm looking at my phone to see what I'm doing next. Yeah, I'm still doing that rookie stuff using a guide disgracefully, so. I mean, everyone uses a guide, but there's a proper way of doing it that I've, without ethics, refuse to use, refuse to learn, or adapt to. Okay, 1,200. Yes, 720. All we need is a couple of good battles, and we'll be strong enough to defeat everyone in this game. When you finish all your peaks rolls. Yeah, wipe them out. Just do that for me, sugar. Sweet. I don't like the way this is looking right now. Good thing they're weak. Yeah, but they have magic, so that's a problem. Alright, this will clean things up. Again, whatever stat affects magic defense, that probably stopped Cecil from getting clapped. Alright, it's time to stamp bam the confirm button. Yep, we got this. Operation spam the confirm button. Hit that. Oh, this is also a 5-floor dungeon. No critical thinking needed, right? Status. After we're done, I might have to take a trip outside. Yeah, I definitely will. Alright, just finish this. Yeah, keep going after butts, nameless enemies. That'll make things a lot easier for me. Wow. Flea, flea, flea. I'm a flea boy right now. This is how long I've been doing this stuff. I'm already in that mode of thought. If a battle wasn't gonna give me EXP, I'm not gonna be in it. Ankeg. These idiots again. I'm out. I have a feeling you can't run from these guys. Either that or it's gonna be really inconvenient. Either way, cease and desist? What's the word? I'm sure there's one chest I'm missing, but just looking at a lot of the treasure in this dungeon, a lot of it isn't that interesting. Except for the elemental stuff, but it's neither here nor there at the moment. With the mechanics of this game, you could think the Dawn of Souls version was made by a grandmother or something. Trying to make sure you got your vitamins and minerals. Alright. Done. The whole team got a level up? The whole team got a level up. I can't believe that. And we got another antidote to spare. We never fought these guys before. Get out of my way, boy! Now I'm where I need to be if I wanted to get those level 6 spells. So I could backtrack to get Thundaga for Vivi, seeing as once I buff everyone up, Vivi isn't going to have anything to do. I'm not going to make him blast Fyraga on the boss's stage for this dungeon for obvious reasons. That's just not going to happen, baby boy. And believe it or not, this boss doesn't really have an elemental weakness. Not ice, not thunder. It's weird. Usually I'm really under-leveled for these Final Fantasy games. This one, not so much. I think I'm halfway done with all the levels that I need. Okay, Mount Gulag, Basement 4. Move over to the southeastern corner. Yeah, you do go up and down. So this place has some twists and turns. It's 5 stories, but it tries to make it a little interesting, I guess. And I emphasize and strain my voice just enough to get the point that it's a mix-up, but it's only marginally more interesting than the previous dungeon. But at least we go in one take. There's no, like, annoying mini-boss. Back on. Go south. Until you can get more. Okay. Okay. Oh, I gotta go west a little. At what point do I go west and stop going south? Go south and you can. South until you can't no more. What up?
Adele's here.
Oh.
She can come and clean here.
Yeah, she can.
You want to stay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the cleaning lady. My hit points are low. Good thing it didn't take a hit. All right. Back on basement 4. Gold needle. Good for any cockatrice. Attaboy. Alright, now that the room's empty for a bit, I'm gonna go back to commentating a little bit. Let me see. That was a big number. Oh, 306? Forgot about them. And that about does it for this episode. It's been your boy, Mr. Wonk 7. I'll give you what would have been my commentary much later. And respect the king.